What is up, drone fam? This is KRUSER, where I show you how to make professional drone videos. And today is a special day because DJI just announced a new product, the RoboMaster S1, their first ground vehicle product that they've just come out with. And it is fantastic. And in this video, I'm gonna go over all the specifics of it, pricing, and pretty much everything you can do with this new product. Check it out. Just a couple days ago, DJI teased us with a little video showing some wheels, some gears, and kind of hinting at maybe a first-person view racing drone or a race car of some sorts, but they just dropped the news tonight, and it looks like it's a mix between a race car and a robo-tank, and something that you can pretty much configure and play with all by yourself, and it's pretty awesome. Just to give context behind the product of the RoboMaster S1, DJI has been holding competitions in China for years now where competitors can build their own robots and fight each other in an arena, and DJI decided to take it to a next level and release their own product for the public to where they can actually build their own robots with DJI's parts and then be able to compete and fight each other with their robots in their own homes. To me, I think that's pretty awesome. It's got like a turret on the top of it, omnidirectional wheels, so it can pivot and turn in any direction when you're not flying it but driving it. Some other highlighted features of it include being able to shoot water pellet beads. And if you don't want to get your ground dirty with those, you can actually use lasers. And you would use these to compete and fight other tanks with sensors on the sides of them. And then that's how you get each other out and you can play different games. To me, the biggest part that seems interesting is when you buy this product, it actually doesn't come pre-built. You are required to build it yourself and follow an instruction guide. And then once it's built, there's over 40 different programmable settings. And you can actually program this robot to do specific actions based on two different programming languages. One of the programming languages being Scratch, which is what elementary school students use to program and write code. And then the other one for more experienced programmers is Python, which is something that I personally learned when I was in information systems back in college. But pretty much this should be an awesome product to play with and to get to know to using. And after you finish setting up the RoboMaster S1, you are able to do a lot of different fun things with it, like shooting other tanks with its blaster on top, do racing with its four-wheel omnidirectional tires. And then as well, you have a couple other nice features like facial recognition, active tracking like there are in other DJI products, and then as well, line tracking like you have on the floor, and then number tracking where you can have it race and then recognize numbers that you put up around your house or home, and then it can race based off of those. Pretty much, it sounds like an awesome toy or awesome product for children, teenagers. You know, if you're trying to get into a hobby and you want to just try something new, this sounds like the perfect introduction to getting into robotics. And you know what? I think it's a pretty decent price at $499. Considering it is a DJI product, you can expect the price to be a little high. And so I'm not surprised that it is floating around $500. But considering all the fun things you can do with, you know, building your own DJI robot, and then being able to have a ton of fun activities you can do with it, and then the blasters. It just sounds like a whole ton of fun, and I'm super excited to try it out and to buy it. And to go over some of the specs of the RoboMaster S1, you do get a guide for helping you program the different specific parts of the robot, so you're not completely in the dark once you get this product. And then as well, just to go over the camera and the quality of what you're getting, you do get 1080 video, and then as well, when you're looking at it and you're getting the first person view on your tablet or on your iPhone, you get 720 camera quality with that. And then you can also take pictures as well. And the battery life for the Robo S1 is around 35 minutes if you're actively driving it, and then 100 minutes if you're just on standby by letting it stand still. And it also takes a micro SD card for saving your photos and your videos. But maybe with this product coming out, I think DJI is hoping to get robotics and robot fighting maybe more mainstream, because it definitely is something that is up on the rise. Let me know in the comments what you all think of this new product and if this is a great move for DJI for releasing this. I post drone videos weekly and I help drone pilots learn how to make cinematic professional drone videos. So if you're interested in that, check out my other videos and consider subscribing to my channel. And like always, drone fam, take it easy, keep cruising, and I'll see you in the next video.